Hello students, so you have already learned that the radiant heat or thermal radiation is nothing but electromagnetic wave because heat energy from any heated body always transmitted in all directions, spread in all directions in the form of electromagnetic wave by radiation process. And you also know that in case of a black body radiation, that is when a black body is get heated, it emits radiation of all possible wavelengths, means it contains electromagnetic waves of different wavelengths. So since in case of a black body radiation, it emits or contains electromagnetic waves of different wavelengths, so obviously it is very clear that the intensity of this radiant heat energy will not be same for all wavelengths. It will be different for different wavelengths. So that's why the intensity of the radiant heat energy is different for different wavelengths in case of a black body radiation. Okay. And this was first studied by two physicists or two scientists, Lumière and Prinsel. They took a black body and they heated it at different temperatures, and they saw that the energy was really distributed non-uniformly among different wavelengths at different temperatures. And from this experiment, they derived a graph which shows the variation of the intensity of the radiant heat energy with wavelength. And from this experiment they plot a graph. They invented the graph, which showed through a graph which is called the energy or spectral distribution graph or curve. Since our energy is distributed, so it is called energy distribution in case of black body radiation. And since spectrum is also associated, which we have already seen in last video, so that's why it is called energy distribution graph or spectral distribution graph. But since they got this non-uniformity, this variation with their sensor, since in this case the energy, the intensity of the radiant heat energy is distributed non-uniformly, it varies with wavelength. That's why they plotted a graph between this, the intensity of the radiant heat energy against wavelength, which you can see in the graph. Now this graph has so many characteristics. If you notice this graph very carefully, you will be able to see some characteristics. Now at first you can see with the rise of the temperature, isn't it? The rise of the temperature, then you can see there are three temperatures have been shown. Since, as I told, they heated the black body at different temperature, so as we go in the upward direction, temperature increases. It means T1 is the minimum temperature, then T2, then T3. So with the rise of the temperature, you can see the area of the curve increases, which clearly shows that is the intensity of the radiant heat energy increases, which clearly supports the Stefan's law, which we have got as E proportional to T to the power 4. Somehow it follows or obeys or abides, isn't it? It supports Stefan's law. So number one, from this curve we can establish, we can get idea of the clarification of Stefan's law. Number two, you can see this is the increasing order of the wavelength, isn't it? And you can see at a particular temperature, take any temperature as example, suppose T1. So as we go in the increasing order of the wavelength, so gradually with increasing the intensity value of the radiant heat energy at a particular value, the graph reaches its peak value, which indicates its maximum energy, that is radiant heat energy. Then suddenly with the increase of wavelength, it decreases. It is also applicable for temperature T2 also. With the rise of the wavelength, its radiant heat energy increases, reaches maximum value, then drops down. Also applicable for T3 also. So it clearly indicates that for a given particular temperature, fixed temperature, its radiant heat energy reaches its maximum value at a particular wavelength, then drops down, which clearly indicates its non-uniform distribution. Okay. Number three, the most strange and the most interesting fact, which we are going to get a new law. Okay, if you can see with the rise of the temperature, okay, the peak of the curve is shifting towards the left side, that is towards the descending order of the wavelength. How clearly see in case of temperature T1, when the temperature is minimum T1, you can see the peak of the curve is here, that is wavelength is lambda m1. It means 1 for temperature T1, m for maximum value, here lambda n is the maximum wavelength for is the value of the wavelength for maximum intensity for radiation of maximum intensity or maximum intensity energy. Okay, then 42, when temperature 42, you can see the peak of the value is here. the peak of the curve here, which indicates maximum radiant energy. But here you can see, if we draw perpendicular, now wavelength shifts towards the decreasing order, isn't it? For temperature 2, which is also maximum for second curve. Third curve, further, it is maximum here, but again, if you draw perpendicular, again, you see. So as the temperature increases, the peak of the curve, the peak value of peak of the curve shifts towards the left side. We can clearly see that in case with the increase, with the decrease, that is, with the rise of the temperature, the graph reaches its peak value, that is, its peak, that is maximum radiant heat energy, is maximum for decreasing wavelength. Isn't it? As the temperature increases, the maximum radiant energy reaches its maximum value for decreasing wavelength. These are the wavelengths associated to radiation of maximum intensity. So, this was first experimentally proved by Wien. It is called Wien's law or Wien's law, or so Wien's law. So, according to which, after his name, it is called Wien's. It was first observed and experimentally proved and invented by Wien. So, after his name, it is called Wien's law, which states that if the temperature of a black body increases, then the radiation of maximum intensity or maximum energy emitted distribution or radiation shifts towards the shorter wavelength, isn't it? Just see, lambda 1, it was the emitted energy, lambda 1, T2 shifts towards the left side, T3 left side. So as the temperature is increasing, the intensity for the radiation for maximum intensity is just shifting towards the shorter wavelength, isn't it? So this is the mathematical expression of Wien's law, which clearly states that, if T is the absolute temperature of a black body, then if lambda m is its wavelength for maximum energy emitted radiation or radiation for maximum intensity, then lambda m is equal to constant, which clearly states that the lambda m is inversely proportional to temperature. It means the corresponding wavelength, the wavelength corresponding to the radiation of maximum intensity, is inversely proportional to its absolute temperature of the black body. Clear? This means if the temperature of the black body increases, the wavelength for maximum intensity radiation decreases, and if absolute temperature decreases, then wavelength associated to maximum intensity radiation increases. Inversely proportional. Now just try to remember, in case of absorption power and imaging power, what did I state? It is when we get, when we start hitting any object, at the beginning we cannot see any color, isn't it? But it doesn't mean that it doesn't emit any radiation. Further, as its temperature, isn't it? If we heat it further, if its temperature further increases, then gradually and slowly it appears red hot. Then at the finally, when it is heated too much, then finally it appears white. It emits white color, isn't it? Then what did I say? I said that initially, when the body was cold at T is equal to 0, then when immediately we heat it, it doesn't radiate any color. But it doesn't mean that it doesn't radiate any electromagnetic wave. As I said, in case of nature of thermal radiation, there are so much similarities between thermal radiation, that is radiant heat, and wave, visible light. There are so many similarities, but only one difference, that is that in the wavelength. In case of thermal radiation, the wavelength of thermal radiation is slightly greater than that of visible light. And what is the maximum wavelength of visible light? That is a red light, and above it just infrared star. So when a body is just started heating, isn't it, when you just begin to heat a body, though it doesn't emit any color, after that, when we further heat it, that its temperature increases, then it appears at red hot. But it doesn't mean that before grabbing the red color, it doesn't get heated. It gets heated, but we cannot see it. Why? Because since at the beginning of the heating of a body, of iron, it emits infrared, which is invisible. Why? Because it is just beyond the red light, isn't it? Now, wavelength from violet to red, we all know this is the range of, this is the wavelength of, range of wavelength of visible light. We all know that below violet is invisible, is very small, and above red it is also greater. So between violet and red is the visible light. Since at the beginning, if we heat an iron, it emits electromagnetic wave, but that is infrared. Infrared is of higher wavelength than that of red. As we heat it more, it starts to emit red light, which supports Wien-Schwan's law. When the temperature was low, initially when we heat any iron or any metal body, it is not visible, because at particular time its wavelength is greater, is higher. Initially at low temperature, wavelength is greater. As temperature increases, according to Wien's displacement law, we have written Wien's law, it will be Wien's displacement law. So as gradually we heat the body, temperature increases, what does, following the graph, it becomes red hot. And since the wavelength of infrared light, of infrared wave, is more than red light, so it drops then red, then slowly it becomes white. Why? Because at the particular time when it is heated too much, all sorts of wavelength are present inside it, and it's look like white. So it follows the Wien's displacement law. As temperature increases, wavelength decreases. As temperature increases, wavelength decreases. Clear? So that's why when a body is heated at low temperature, at first it emits infrared, which is not visible. As temperature increases, wavelength shifts toward the shorter wavelength, that is red. The wavelength of red is less than that of red light. So this is the mathematical expression of Wien's displacement law. And here you can see constant, that constant, the value of constant is 0.0029 meter into Kelvin. Why? If we take lambda in meter and absolute temperature in Kelvin, this value is 0.0029 Kelvin, which is called Wien's constant. Okay, and through this we can measure, we can calculate the temperature inside the stars, sun, okay, etc. So this is energy distribution and black body radiation and Wien's displacement law. Okay, hope you have understood. So meet in next video.